Finally, reports continue to come in concerning the Royal Swiss cruise liner, which went missing yesterday in the Bermuda Triangle. As of this morning, there is still no news concerning the ship or her crew. The Bermuda Coast Guards are adamant that a modern ship of this size can simply not have just disappeared. And nautical authorities around the globe are puzzled by the disappearance. At this point, there have been no distress calls received, and there have been no signals from the ship's black box recorder. One thing everyone is certain upon, the ship of this size cannot have sunk without a trace. It is a strange set of circumstances which has been described as without precedent in nautical history. Well, Ron, how's our weather shaping up for this weekend?
Thanks, Gwen. Well, that certainly is a strange case, but I can assure you it is not the fault of the weather. There are absolutely no adverse weather systems anywhere in the Caribbean region, and the outlook for the Cayman Islands remains warm and sunny.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, and roll to break.
Things have happened at sea, but I can't think of any.
Yeah, well, we would have been the first ones off, except Mr. Motormouth over here got us in trouble with customs.
Were you cannon already?
Customs problems?
Yeah, this scanner guy was like, any metal on you?
Yeah, so get this, right? So I say, only the shirt, dude, right? And I spin around and I'm like, got a message for you.
Assholes to you, classic!
Yeah, very funny. 4 hour wait for me? And a full body search for him.
I think I kind of liked it.
Oh. Well, you're here now. Let the vacation begin.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome back to the Cayman, man.
Thank you. Nice. Hey, is that beach bar in Northside? Is that still open? What's it called again? The Driftwood?
Sure is.
Yeah?
It's kind of a quiet place.
Oh, quiet's good.
Okay, I'll have you there in no time.
Now, this is just a beach bar, right?
Of course it is.
Look, baby, I know what you're thinking, but it's quiet, it's out of the way, and in a great location, okay?
Not to worry, hon. It can't happen again. You're safe here.
Okay, because I couldn't do that. I mean,
Oh my God, no way, it's just too creepy.
Look, forget about it. Let's just have some fun, okay? Let's do this. Cheers.
Sounds good to me.
All right. All right. Woo!
As I drift on, waiting for the day when I take your hand, sing your songs, maybe you would say, come lay with me and love me, I would surely stay. Now I feel I'm going to like the sound of a windmill go round. I guess I'll always be the soldier of fortune.
So, what are you looking at?
Nothing. I thought I saw something moving out there.
See if the sun is over the yard, arm.
12:01. Practically evening.
Good. You know I never drink in the morning.
I believe you. The usual.
You bet. Nice shirt.
Yeah, well, it's a bit tighter than in 1976 at the St. Denis Theater in Montreal, but I'm in it.
The holes, are they part of the effect?
Nah, nail holes. I took this one down off the t-shirt rafter. You're not working today.
Well, you know me. I like writing, but I hate the paperwork.
So what, you're searching for inspiration?
Au contraire. Today, I have a big story. But first, a couple of cold ones to help all the wills of modern journalism.
Yeah, well, why break the habits of a lifetime? Boy, things have been so quiet, and this divorce is so expensive.
That's because it's worth it.
It's okay for you. I don't want to lose everything that I got. Can you believe that a woman would stoop so low as to sell a man's vinyl and the best collection of rock shirts ever assembled? This is rock history, man. It's priceless. She will never get my shirts from me.
Especially now that you've nailed them to the fucking roof. I see Teddy's keeping you company again.
It's nice to have a friendly face around the place.
That is not a friendly face. Has he been boring you?
I heard that. You know, I'll make a comeback.
Hard to make a comeback when you haven't been anyplace else. So, Tom, what's the big story?
Why don't you take a look outside?
Holy God!
Dude, check it out, check it out!
Oh, wait,
Jaws, you gotta get a picture of me and Jaws. Come on.
Ready?
Come on.
Ready?
Watch his lip. Dude!
Okay, ladies, right this way.
Man, you guys look amazing. Caribbean living must agree with you.
You have no idea.
Is that? Dude, nice wheels. Manny. You must be making some good money.
Man, I have enough money to last me for the rest of my life. Unless, of course, I buy something. Hey, you want to drive?
Are you shitting me? Dude, let me at her, man.
You can't drive. You don't know where we're going.
Minor problem. I'll be the navigator.
We'll be right back. Shifting around to the east.
I don't know. I noticed a really bad smell coming in. Never smelled anything like it before.
Good. Thought it had another accident again.
Teddy, will you shut up, for Christ's sake?
Finally, we are receiving news on the Royal Swiss cruise liner that went missing yesterday in the Bermuda Triangle. The ship is reported to have drifted ashore on North Side. There are still no sightings of her crew or passengers. It's a strange conundrum, and one that just gets stranger and stranger. Over to you, Ron.
Thanks, Gwen. Strange indeed. Well, there's not much change in the forecast. We're in for some high temps, ranging from the high 80s to the low 90s. Remember, folks, it's a scorcher out there. So drink plenty of fluids, stay out of the sun, and pray for anyone who was aboard that ship.
Nice work, Tiger. Same place?
You bet.
Mm-hmm. I'm hornier than a devil on powdered rhino horn.
Well, I got something that'll make you hornier.
See you at 7.
Okay.
This is the place. Brandon, solicitors and attorneys for the undead. Well, let's burn ahead. I have an appointment with Mr. Berlin. That's me. Welcome to FMZ. More fun. All of us are Berlins. We all speak Greek and Latin. So why use Latin? It's a dead language. Just that little joke. Fucking hilarious. I'm Richard D.K. Attorney. But everyone was me. Dick.
So how did you reach the animated status, Dick?
Fuck, if I know, I should surrender the missiles, smoke under the water, making Bill fucking zombies.
The bastards didn't sell us! It was a country and western-themed cruise!
Yeah, Brad played Vienna, Rosemont, Texas, every fucking night.
You want me to sue the cruise line for a member cruelty?
Nah, my client and my honorary have to serve the own papers. I'm Mr. Dan Stormbringer. He owns that Driftwood bar.
He is my ex-husband. That sounds so bastard. So go on, honey, and open that shitty little beach bar.
The Driftwood. I know the place. He's got the early dead jukebox, all heavy rock, and metal tunes.
As a little show up at court, that jukebox now legally belongs to me.
Mr. Dan Stormbringer? That's a rather unusual surname.
No shit, Sherlock. The slippery bastard that brought his vitamin has been.
Then the thieving swine bolted from Canada down here to Cayman.
How the hell did you track him down?
Easy, what other head praying moron would name himself after a Deep Purple album?
Slender! Strange choice. I prefer Lamok to Nana.
Come on, now, Ben. Where's that really young man?
Oh, shit.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Officer Chisholm from the Northside Station. Are you aware you were doing 50 in a 30-mile-an-hour zone?
Was I? I'm sorry, officer. You see, we just visited the islands, and I guess we got a little bit carried away. You know, the roads are just so empty.
Well, that's no excuse. There could be children crossing at any time. We're here to keep Cayman safe for everyone. License and registration, please.
Sure thing, Officer Chisholm.
Because you never know, maybe one day I just might save your life.
That's a very profound thought, officer.
Says here you're supposed to be wearing glasses.
Oh, that's all right. I have contacts.
Well, I don't care who you know. You have to abide by the law just like everyone else.
Okay.
Is this your car, sir?
Yes, sir, it is.
Well, you need to have a little bit more control or we'll be left behind the wheel.
I will, officer. And thanks.
And have a good day.
I may just save your life one day. I didn't think so.
Well, from what I've gathered, we found that floating out at sea, no one on board.
Well, I can understand that. The last cruise I took with my ex-wife made me want to abandon ship, too.
Hang on. Turn up the TV. Nothing like being second to the story.
Tammy, what can you tell us about this mystery ship?
Well, Jordan, we've learned from sources close to the government that this very ship disappeared from radar for approximately 48 hours as it went through the Bermuda Triangle and then suddenly reappeared today here at the north coast of Grand Cayman Island.
Tammy, is it true that no one was aboard?
That is correct, Jordan. It appears as though everyone, the passengers and crew, suddenly abandoned ship for no reason.
What do you mean, abandoned ship?
Well, Jordan, when they discovered this ship, they found that all the lifeboats were gone.
That is amazing, Tammy. Do they have any theory as to why everyone abandoned ship? And where?
No, not at this time, Jordan, but they are certain of one thing. It was not pirates.
Why is that?
Well, after the Coast Guard did a thorough search of the ship, they found nothing missing in the way of jewelry, clothing, etc. Even the pots in the galley had boiled dry from being neglected.
That is spooky, to say the least. Thanks for your report, Tammy. We'll look forward to seeing you at the top of the next news hour.
My pleasure. Looking forward to it. Okay, everyone, that's a wrap.
All right, we'll get those shots you wanted.
Okay, thanks. I'm gonna stick around here and probe around for a bit. See you back here in an hour.
Okay.
So, does Mr. Stormley not have any value assets? You're right. Why, you think you came to a tax haven?
Yeah, he brought a priceless collection of rock memorabilia, which is now mine.
We need to move fast. Delay leads to decay.
Okay, very funny. We need to serve these papers today, before we fall apart.
No problem. The monument is composed and online as a short film. So, let me get this straight. We make a fucking film, then what? The film runs in that big decay is coming to Driftwood.
Which online platform do we use?
Zentrum.
Zentrum? How did you know about Zentrum? It's top secret.
I know about the special military operation by a Marine Corps, codename Stormbringer.
He's a spy. Kill the little shipman now!
Stay still, you new bastard.
Forget the little shit. Let's make this fucking film and get it on ZenTube.
Sounds like we got company.
Great. More people.
What's wrong with more people?
The more people I meet, the more I like my dog.
Why can't you just be normal?
Because normality is for people who can't handle liquor.
Wow. Now this place is cool.
So do you like it?
Oh, I do. It feels like a nice, quiet, safe place.
Hey, nice shirt, dude. Great album.
Yeah, you'll be sorely.
Yeah, but you know, down below, man, that's gotta be rocking.
Down below? He might have gone above. He sang on heaven and hell.
Well, that is classic vinyl, amigo, but Dio in heaven? No way. He wouldn't know anybody.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Anyway, what can I get you?
I'll have a caper. We hear it's the best beer on the island.
You heard right.
Make that four. I'm buying.
Check this out. They've got a jukebox and a pool table. We should have come here in the first place.
Whoa, love the shirts, dude. Hey, you selling those?
No way, man. Those things are part of a valuable collection. But I can see by your attire that you must be here for the first night of the Battle of the Band.
Unfortunately not. I'm just showing some friends around.
Have some coffee, please. You fancy a game, son?
Yeah, why not?
Okay, guys, you only have time for a couple of games. I have to close up soon and set up for Battle of the Band. The band's arrived.
Come, tell me. Let me guess. Oh, you bastard. You lying bastard. You promised me. You said never again.
What? October Philo here? Now? Whoa. What a coincidence.
In coincidence? Oh, you mean like when we went to Miami? They're in Miami. We go to London, they're in London. If we go to Nairobi, are those assholes gonna be in Nairobi too?
Look, maybe they're stalking me, all right? It's definitely weird.
No, you're weird. You mean to tell me nothing about them being here?
Look, baby, I wouldn't want to jeopardize what we have going together, okay? Promise, I knew nothing, nothing about this.
Corporate, you mad bastard, you made it!
Grace was the fate, huh?
I got your email, man. Honestly, didn't think you'd make this one. 500 consecutive gigs in a row. You're as mad as a box of fucking frogs. Later, man.
Yeah, later.
Hey, do you mind if we plug in and have a sound check?
No problem.
Cheers, thanks.
Oh, by the way, I've got the link to the site. Hot Pips, is she here?
So then. It's like so over. Don't talk to me. Don't touch me, don't ring me, and don't even come near me. Take your sick little fetish somewhere else. For once, it might be nice if you could learn how to do it without insisting your partner wear a damn laminate.
What? What did I do? AAA? Access all areas? You gotta get one of these things, dude.
Anybody got a couple of cigarettes?
You don't.
No. I want to use the filters as earplugs.
Manny, my man. Seeing as we're going to be here a while, how about you and me go take a little walk down the beach? Come on!
Hey, what's the rush? You just got here.
Let's go down the beach.
It's getting like a desert in here.
Teddy, I swear one of these days I'm going to ban you from here for life.
You can't do that to me, old buddy. We got too many miles between us. Besides, who else is going to keep you company? It's not like you got people standing outside the door waiting to get in.
Rush.
It's
not like you.
Oh, I'm just in the mood.
God, you're here.
As a matter of fact, yes. I have to be first on the story, as usual.
Well, it shouldn't take long. As I recall, you always finished first. Can I have the seven fathoms, please?
Oh, yeah, the good stuff.
Oh, only the best for me. That's why I got out of the rag business.
Oh, come on. We all know the editor's wife didn't like the competition.
You're such an ass, you know that? She was never any competition. And let us never forget, some of us are just very small men. Where's the washroom?
We're there.
Now that is one USDA grade A cat.
I take it you know the woman.
Oh yeah. We used to work pretty closely together. Until she got caught doing her own sports section with the editor.
Hello? Oh, hi, Jordan. Oh, yes, the story.
So is it true about the,
That's bullshit. These so-called reporters of today can't handle the pace of real reporting. They think they're one big superstar just because they're ugly mugs are on TV!
Reports are coming in from all parts of the island of unexplained attacks. Everyone is being urged to stay indoors and lock all doors and windows. The government is attempting to stabilize the situation and has asked for calm and extreme vigilance. We had hoped to bring you a report from Tammy Bodden, but it seems that we have lost caution! Ah!
Taking over the whole friggin' island.
Come on, let's bring them in. For the blue, 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 the blue
Really starting to get serious.
Sure, we're safe here. There's no way they can get in.
Oh yeah, all the glass is hurricane proof, so they won't be getting in through the windows, and all the doors are double bolted. Except for the bathroom.
Hello? Hello?
Oh.
See this.
Whoa, she's still trying to make out. I wonder what it'd be like to call a zombie.
You need some serious help, you know that?
Maybe, but why is she doing that?
Looks like some kind of last behavior loop. They're just acting as if they're still on vacation. You see, some people go on holiday to get laid. Others just chase stupid metal bands.
Yeah, they might not be getting in that way, no, but they might get in that way.
Smart zombies.
Where did he get that drill gun?
She must have got it from the storeroom.
Oh, great. Well, let's just hope you don't have a chainsaw in there.
You want the straight answer?
Oh my God, we're gonna die.
Find the money.
So much metal addled your mind? Can't you see?
See what?
Their brains have semi-cognitive. They're imprinted with the last behavior pattern that they experienced when they were alive. It's an autodidactic process.
Yeah, I see. So why the money?
They're tourists you bring down yonder? They want to spend money and have a good time.
Wait, so now what?
Gotta sell them stuff.
Shit, so what kind of things do tourists want?
The usual shit, like t-shirts.
Oh, no way, those are not for sale. No way, not Holy Diver, no, that was the 83 tour. Not Stormbringer, no, never.
What? We're saving your life here.
Oh, all right, you can give them, who do we think we are, if you have to.
Oh, I agree, dude, that's one lame-ass album.
Burns? No way, not Burns.
Too late.
I've been mistreated. Oh, come on, man. Not my Lizzy shirt as well.
It's a 50.
Okay, take it, but no more sales until we get organized.
I'm sorry. Sales over.
Shit, does anybody know how to kill a zombie?
I seen them do it with all vinyl records.
No way, man. That is a limited edition.
Feel your pain, man. But trust me, dude. Lemmy, he would have wanted it this way.
No, and I mean no.
A machete? You've got a machete? Why the hell did you say so?
Well, I was saving it for an emergency.
Come on,
give me the Teddy, listen. Help an old friend. Take this and see if you can get that dildo with the drill gun away from my window.
You'll have another friggin' machete behind the bar.
It's a dangerous neighborhood.
Come on, guys. Help me out over here. Guys.
stupid!
And it's a fight freaking hot! This is war!
Expect us to do. Maybe you thought we could just stroll over there and join them for a beer.
You know, you don't have to be so sarcastic. I just thought that we could, you know, get to them somehow.
Gwen, you know I love you, and I'd do anything in the world for you. But please, just for tonight, no more bright ideas.
You are right over there!
Slide open the window. Dan, that you? You guys okay?
Yeah, I got nearly 800 for my shirts. I might try and sell a few albums later. Why don't you guys come over here? You'd be safer.
Screw that. Why don't you make a run over here?
Hell no! There's more of us in here!
Ron, we have to try. We'll die in here!
There's no way in hell I'm going out there!
Ron, how long have we been meeting on Fridays?
40 years?
Five. Have I ever asked anything of you? You ever listened to me?
No.
Right. So just shut up and do as I say, or else I'll use your dust balls for their distraction.
We've got a little bit of a problem.
What problem?
You don't know why I rent this place from you?
Yeah, I do. You told me that you rent it so that you can fool around with Gwen. Everybody knows that. Oh, hi, Gwen!
Look, this is a little awkward, but you know how sometimes you like to spice up your sex life?
Ron, I'm not sure where you're going with this, but I don't think this is the time. And I'm just not a group sex kind of guy.
Oh, not that. You see, we're handcuffed.
Well, where's the key?
A zombie ate it.
Well... Just get Gwen to help you and run over!
It's not that simple. They ate our clothes, too!
Tell you what, I'll cause a distraction.
So if I come over, you promise not to look?
Scout's honor!
Guys, we're going out there.
All right, you guys gotta do this now!
Okay, we're coming!
I've always loved a tiger, and I always will.
Grr. Munchkin, let's do this.
Okay. Okay, no peeking now.
Okay, you zombie fucks. I'm gonna rock, and you're gonna roll. Come and get some.
Let's
rents the cottage from me.
Rented?
Shit, yeah. He was such a good payer, too.
We've got our own problems.
What's the point? There's too many of them. We'll never kill them all.
You're absolutely right. Look, see that building over there? We gotta make our way over to it.
Well, why that building?
Well, it's the kitchen. It's got hurricane shutters on all the windows. It's like a small fortress in there.
Jackie, you better go check on our friend over there.
Are you all right? Tom, are you feeling any aches in the joints or nausea to the stomach? Tom, are you feeling pain? Tom, I can't help you if you don't answer me.
I can see you graduated at the top of your class. How many autopsies have you performed on dead people?
All of my autopsies have been performed on dead people.
Teddy, will you shut up?
Sorry, dude, but no one beats my girl. Except me.
Thanks. How are you?
I don't give a shit what anyone says, but I'm having a drink now.
Chisholm, Officer Webb. I knew you guys would get through.
Just doing our job to keep K-Man safe.
We've had reports there's people held up at Driftwood. I need you guys to go down there and bring them back alive.
Well, I don't know about him, but you can count on me, sir.
It's getting dark out there. You're gonna need special issue equipment.
I agree, sir. It's getting pretty nasty out there. A general issue of shotguns, eh? Blow them away. Kaboom. Pow, pow, pow. Eat lead, brain dead.
No, we're issuing these to all officers.
Flashlight, sir.
I see you impressed. You'll find there's batteries in there.
So, no firearms then, sir?
Not up the last time.
That was an accident, sir.
The word from the top, this is a standard operation. So, no guns, no violence, and especially, no accidents. Just the firm and fair application of the law.
So, you wanted to give him a caution, sir?
Until we have clarification, these things are technically tourists. We don't want Cayman to get the reputation as the island that blows away its tourists. Especially on the first offence.
See, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Don't these guys know the law? Aren't they concerned about their health? No smoking 10 feet from the building! Can't you guys read? Give me that machete. I'll lose my life, but I ain't gonna lose my license.
Then, I'll go.
Oh man, no. I'll go. This is my bar. My captain has gotta go down with this shit.
Does that mean that I'm in charge of the bar till you come back, old buddy?
Absolutely not. Okay, on the count of three, ready?
Ready.
Okay, one, two...
Why can't I be in charge? You and I have known each other the longest.
That's exactly why you're not in charge, for Christ's sake.
You have a real attitude problem, you know that?
All right, screw the count. When I nod my head, you open that door.
Okay. Did he actually leave anybody in charge of the bar?
Shut up, Teddy!
How's he doing?
Incredible. He must be ambidextrous.
I would give my right arm to be ambidextrous.
Guys, he's heading back.
He hasn't been bit, has he? This is our lives here. We can't be too careful.
No, I hate to say this, but he's
open
right. Even just a small scratch, and if he's bit, he could infect us. Who knows?
I just risked his life for us.
I understand, but he said it himself. Do not open the door if he's been bitten.
He hasn't been bit.
You're positive. You haven't been talking or doing anything else that would have distracted you. You can say for certainty that he is clean. Have you been infected?
Open the freaking door, will ya? Come on! Jesus, open that door!
Come on, old buddy, we gotta be sure!
Open the goddamn door, will ya? Come on! You bastards, get away from me! Open the freaking door! What the hell was that all about?
Come on, old buddy, we have to be certain.
I wish I had got bit so I could rip you a new asshole!
I told you me and Dan is tight.
Free season ticket on the one-way ride. know what happens next? I sing Zulu.
Get ready.
Goodbye, Jackie. You know.
What?
I. I got it. Don't you see? When people die, they become zombies. When music dies, it becomes country or western.
Hey guys, let's use this lull to try and get rid of some of this crap.
Hey, wait a minute. I got an idea. Woo! Come on. Bring it on. Batter's up!
Woo! No, dude, this is the way we do it in Canada. Watch the maestro.
Fucking transplants.
This is the Caribbean. Let me show you how it's done. You can bowl cricket?
Sure can.
Six! Drinks all around.
Teddy, you've given me a brilliant idea. You know, these zombies, they're completely useless when they're on the booze. Get up to 7 fathoms.
You on about giving away liquor again?
Teddy, if you don't like it,
don't mind if I do. Give me that.
Ridiculous. That would be suicide.
Without a mind. I would rather take my chance out there than die in here. Heartless. Tonight, I make my mark on this world. I will do what I can to live forever. Or die trying. See you around somewhere, my friends.
This is insane. He's gonna die out there.
Oh, you don't know Teddy.
Guys, looks like they mean business.
We're gonna have to make a break for the kitchen soon.
Why don't we just give them what they want? Beer.
Okay, guys, look for a chance for us to make a run for it. We're almost out of beer. And we'll keep coming.
Before we go, there's something I always wanted to tell you.
I know. I love you too.
What? No, remember the camera? It was never really stolen.
You mean?
Yeah, I was the one that posted a new picture of you on the map.
Pass. You mean all this time you haven't been able to put your love in?
Look, guys, I don't think this is exactly the time or the place.
This is the perfect time.
I absolutely agree with you.
Look, I am so sorry. You don't understand what I've been through every time I see you. Look, with everything I have inside me, I am so, so sorry. Ever forgive me?
Love you.
Now, the only problem is, this is the last beer.
Yeah.
Yeah, Teddy! Woo!
Oh my God, Teddy, you're alive!
Of course I am!
And I didn't even know you were Scottish!
Everybody knows there's a wee bit of Scotch in everyone in Cayman. Some more than others.
Any beer left? I had to use my bottle of Seven Fathoms rum just to get into the storage shed, and these bastards had already cleaned it out.
No, we're tapped out too.
Sons of bitches.
Come on, follow back of me. Onward to the kitchen.
All right, let's go, guys. Betty, get your ass in here.
Don't worry about me. I am fully armed and ready for battle.
Teddy, forget the Braveheart bullshit. Get your ass in here.
If ever we were brethren, let it be now. It's the battle I want, not words.
Hey, dude. I love you, man.
Never tell another man that you love him. Batty boy.
Be safe in here.
Forgive me if I don't jump on the bandwagon and believe you, but I've heard that before.
Did you give it up already? We're alive, aren't we?
You? Don't talk to me.
No, wait a minute. You forgave me. I saved your life.
Yeah, I forgave you, but it doesn't mean I'm not angry for what you did.
Don't worry about it, dude. She'll get over it.
Bullshit!
I don't know. I was... probably the most colossal screw-up I've had in my entire life.
Hey, you're young. Don't worry. You'll top that.
I don't know, but you ever do something to someone that you care a lot about that you just completely screwed up their life?
Yeah, I married her.
I hope you're right, dude. I hope she does get over it.
Bet those pictures were hot.
Oh, dude. Rocks.
Okay, are you two done dreaming yet? Shouldn't we be trying to figure a way out of here?
She's right. I mean, we can't just stay here for the rest of our lives, right?
Look, there's got to be people looking for us. All we got to do is relax, sit tight.
Okay, what if there's nobody out there that's going to come and help us? I mean, what if the whole island really has been taken over by these cannibals?
Well, then I guess our options are limited. Shit, sounds like they got our battering ram. This is it, guys. Gave them a good run, though.
Yeah. We did, didn't we?
Hey, baby. It'd be nice to,
have a family. Some babies of our own.
What? No. What, with the bang, maybe?
I still think you're an asshole. But I do love you. No, I think we may still be some kind. You always get quick anyway.
I'll forgive that remark. Dan, you mind, buddy?
Dear? Now?
Well, can't go outside.
No, or never, Sugarfoot.
Hey! Are you guys infected?
No, we're okay.
Are you? Wait a minute, I remember you two. Where are the other two?
Gone. But kind of. They're probably outside eating people right now as we speak.
So how are things going out there?
Everything's under control now. As far as I can tell, that's the last of them out there.
Well, I guess a major thank you is in order, officer.
No need, just doing my job to keep K-Man safe.
Well, I guess you ended up saving our lives after all.
Put your buddy away there. You guys come with me. Let's get you out of here.
That's the best idea I've heard in a long time, officer. Well, like, except for the Big Bang idea.
Book these two for indecent exposure, lewd behavior, and the possession of a feather duster with the intent to tickle. Book this one for smoking within 10 feet of a public building.
You know, babe, you could probably make for a pretty foxy zombie.
What?
I should have missed it from my plan, Emmy. In the wake of the special military operation, I was just treating you for the Green War. So I needed our help to go to the Marine Corps, when they source heroes, they are not hiding bodies. Because I left my fiancé hiding my client, got very active, and ran up with a hardcore brain eaters, although I didn't have some sympathy, as all the habits quite high. What you can do is drag down millions of enemies of the undead army. The peace treaty is good news for everyone. We don't eat brains, and they don't shoot us. It's a win-win. The real men are already behind bars. Let's hope they stay there. But the rest of the members of the undead have already been integrated into society. Some have even become royals. Others perform a more meaningful job. The greatest gift of all from the peace treaty is the undead get free tickets to the Battle of the Landslide at the Driftwood for life.
My fiancé and I love to party all night long.